Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you want to see my upcoming tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the 25th episode about JavaScript basics. In the previous episode, we worked on the object method, and today we'll work on the built-in object. We can get built-in object from the MDN website. So open new tab and search for standard built-in object. Open the first link and on the left hand side you will see lots of different built-in objects. We won't use all of them. We will use some of them in our example. The first object we will work is date. So click on them. And on the left hand side, you will see lots of different prototype and methods. You can use any of them. For example, if you want to show the month, you can use getMonth method. If you want to show the minute, you can use getMinutes and so on. If you scroll down, you will see a method called toDateString. This will help to convert the date into string. We will use them in this example, but for now, click on examples. To create a date, you have to create a variable and assign them to new date. Now, let's get started. So first, open the text editor and open the 25th folder, built-in object. Open start and main.js. To create a date, we have to create a variable and assign them to new date. So copy that from the website and paste it over here. Change the variable name into current date. We have to convert them into string, so add console.log current date, and we have to add the method to date string, so add dot to date string. To check the preview, open the browser. Open developer tool, go to console and refresh the page. You should see the current date over here. Now let's work on other object. On the left hand side, scroll down and search for math. Again, in this object, you will see lots of different properties and methods that we can use. Now, let's use absolute number. This helps to convert negative number into positive number. Let's see how to use them. Open your text editor. And you can simply add console.log. Math.abs. Inside bracket, you can add minus number 50, for example. If you refresh the site, you should see 50. Now, let's work on another method. On the left hand side, if you scroll down, you will see random. It helps to generate the random number every time you refresh the page. Let's see how it works. Add console.log math.random. Open the browser, and now every time you refresh the page, you should see a random number over here. Now let's work on another object. On the left hand side, if you scroll down, you should see string. Again, it has got different properties and methods that we can use. For now, let's use string length. It helps to find the length of the string. Let's see how it works. Add variable my name and assign them to any string. add console.log, myname.lint. Bibic has got 5 different characters, so if you refresh the page, you should see 5 over there. Great. Now let's use method of the string charAt. It helps to display characters at different location in a string. Let's see how it works. First, create a variable job and assign them to any string. Add console.log job.charAt and a position number. It starts from 0. So in the example, the position of D start from 0, E, 1, S, 2, and so on. If you refresh the page, you should see E. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on Document Object Model or DOM. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link below. Thank you and see you soon.